this morning. She did a phenomenal job. The only problem with the house right now is it's too clean. You've never had it this clean. We're now spoiled. It is immaculate, but it's a wonderful, wonderful.
Thank you. Miss Dudley, President. The following students to receive certificates for participation deaths. Catherine Schlichting, primary one. Lauren Wilkins, primary one. Lauren Libera, primary two. Patrick Harden, primary two.
Today is June 4, 1994. As you saw, the final recital fell on Evan Warsong.
Let's hold you, man. Just under your chin. We got so many towels now. I tell you what. Why don't you all sit one here in the next row?
Okay,
come on. All right, next row is kneeling down. Good. Now we got it. Yeah, you want me to die? All right, what are we going to say? Cats? Right. Okay, let's say it.
I got red and orange and green and blue and purple too.
Excuse me, wait a minute. What is your name?
Carlin.
Carlin what?
It won't come out.
Carlin.
And how old are you?
9.
And what's today's date?
Already.
July 2nd.
What
July
year?
2nd.
What year?
94.
Okay. And what's your name? Excuse me, young lady, what is your name? You lying on the floor.
Paula.
Your name is Paula?
No, that's Paula.
Wait,
I'm Robin.
You're Robin?
Yeah, that's Paula.
Yeah.
I'm Robin.
Right. How old are you now?
8.
8 years old, okay.
Okay, ready? Okay, there were 4 queens, and they were sitting...
You have anybody visiting you?
They were sitting around the table.
No relatives?
Sipping tea, okay?
No.
And along came...
No cousins?
No cousins.
Well, who's this down here?
The kings came home, and they started getting a fight.
Person.
So the queens called the
You mean this thing right here?
And they all got
Yeah, that's child.
That's just a little bug on the floor.
A bug? That's a little bug.
Hey, bug.
They closed
some of
those exits.
Why?
I know they closed the one at Lunar Square.
Because
of the race.
Oh, you mean for tomorrow?
Tomorrow, yes. Tomorrow, yeah. I got lost again coming up. I took 400, no problem. 285, no problem. I got off on exit 22.
Oh, the exits are all screwed up.
No, yeah, exit 22 is...
Shall we go with it?
I came up there, I passed Wojciech's Deli.
Yeah, we always go on Peeler Road and then, forget where we are.
And then I moved in the right lane and then you're on Peeler Road.
Oh, you can't look at the
right side.
You can't
go that way, you have to...
Yeah, then we got to... Yeah,
well, once I got to Peeler, we went down and got to Shallowford. We took a left there and you're at that...
Kingswood.
What's your name, young man?
Micah.
Micah what?
Aaron Hart.
And how old are you?
12.
What are you going to be...
taller than you.
Well, say that again.
I'm 12 and I'm taller than you.
How old? Wait a minute. How tall are you?
5'7".
How tall were you when I last saw you?
5'3".
Have you grown 4 inches in the last 6 months?
I grew about an inch a month.
You've grown an inch a month? Do you think that'll happen to me?
What?
Move!
Wait a minute. Evan.
Oh, Dad, this is important.
Time.
Micah, is it alright? 20 and a half.
All right, now, tell these guys what it's like being in the Israeli army.
I am a sergeant in the Israeli army. I'm going to tell my husband now.
Ich omring sergeant bivri.
Strong. She went through the Israeli army.
Samal?
Yeah, Samal.
All right, and what kind of weapon did you learn how to shoot in the army?
M16.
M16? Yeah.
Watch out that point, baby.
How long is it?
Oh, why?
Look at how many used to reach, like, down here.
Right?
Oh, my
And how long did you did it take you to learn how to shoot the M16?
Why?
How long did it take you to learn how to fire one?
A couple weeks.
Where are we going, you schmuck?
And then did you teach others how to do it?
Yep.
So nice to see you.
Young men, usually? Is that common? No, Evan, this is not X-rated.
Did you just fart?
No, why?
I'm not. We gotta have this on the tape. Put his finger down.
Evan, I'm gonna say an F-word.
No.
Pussy-fart!
No, don't. Please run. No. Say Frank or say Fred or something like that.
Fudge you.
That's fine.
Yeah, that's good. That's a good
F-word. She meant to say F-U-C-K-U.
No.
Yeah.
You having a good time in the United States?
I'm not having a great time. Thank you. And stay tuned.
And did you have any weeks where you got two faxes? Can you say that?
Really?
And what?
She's a jerk. She's a bitch.
Evan, no cursing.
You can begin the toast like this. I got the love. Okay?
That sounds good.
You have this on tape now on July 2nd, 1994. When I get married, take out this tape and remember what I told him to say.
Shut up! Now Anat's a jerk.
Why is that?
Let me tell you something about Anat.
Why?
She's a hamel! She's a big hamel! Waiting!
Wait a minute.
This is my friend.
Anat, what's it like being in the States with the kids?
When you look at these tapes in about another 4 months when I'm not here,
my mom will kill me.
Yeah, after your mom kills me, I come to your funeral, you're going to remember here. This summer for the rest
I'm
of
help
your
you
life.
Shut up! Come on, get that.
What am I supposed to do? Just stand there like this.
That's it.
Anat!
3 years old.
Kicking his ass.
Taking on two whips.
Oh. We're kicking his butt. That's why we're on top. He's on the bottom. Whoever's on the bottom's losing.
Blind, do you need help?
No. We're just gonna relax today. Oh, shit.
No cursing allowed, this is a...
Evan,
I've got him, Evan. Sorry. Evan, I've got his arm. Evan, get him now. Out of here.
One.
Make a move. Sleeves!
Ryan Morrissey! Oh man, my arm! Oh shit! Ouch! Ow! And I'm breaking the ass.
I want the record to reflect that I'm almost 43 years old. Be naughty, so what?
Yeah, you left right arm.
Oh, God, you're lefty.
Don't hit me, Evan.
Mike, move.
Evan, I can't really move too many places right now.
Wait. What is your name?
Scarlett.
Who did that to your hair?
Paula.
Thank you very, very much.
I hate it.
You hate it?
No, you don't.
I hate them.
Wait a minute. I want to get you in here for a minute, too. Hold on. Let Robin get in front. Get in a row. Everybody's going to introduce themselves. No, you're too close. Move back.
Oh. I don't even know how you
can. Hi, Daddy.
Hi, Brian.
Let me introduce you.
Hi, Daddy.
Who is that?
This is Micah.
No, of course you lost in the last episode.
Who's that sitting over at the table there?
Julian.
Who's that? Micah.
Shelly.
Correa.
There it is.
My bald brother-in-law.
Paul, you're too close. You're messing it up.
No kidding.
Woo! Whose chocolate bar is this?
My brother-in-law's bald, Carla.
Yeah. Mike.
I'm putting on the next one. This is the best one you ever.
Put your right foot in and shake it all about. If you do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around, that's what it's all about. You put your whole self.
One question before we get started.
Yes.
What is today?
Today is Wednesday, August something, 1994.
August 3rd,
1994? August 3rd, 1994.
Okay, now you can take us on the tour.
Now come over here.
Yes.
Put down your book.
This is not fair.
You want my phone too? I don't know who. Come over here with
me. Wait. Robin, do you think it's an American or an Israeli? No, who she's talking to.
Well, if we...
American.
Now, why do you say that?
Because she's talking in English.
Okay.
Now, come over here. I think Chrome's working on the computer. We can see her. Yes, she is working on the computer. She is making a beautiful picture with red and black in it. Carlin, turn around and say hi to the camera. You just have to say hi. That's her, except she...
Carlin, how old are you now?
Oh, here comes Micah. Take a film of him.
Wait a minute, move back.
Yeah, you gotta aim up.
Hi, this is Micah Hart, and he is Carlin's big brother.
Yeah.
Big brother.
Big. All right, Micah, what do you think? You having a good week here?
Yeah, we went to the field today, Evan and I.
Oh, where'd you go?
Zabin.
You played ball at Zabin?
Uh-huh.
Just the two of you?
Uh-huh.
Tell me about it.
What?
Tell me what you did.
Well, he sort of practices bunting and hitting, and I practiced my hitting a little bit. But mostly we just stayed out and I threw him ground balls and he played shortstop. And then I played shortstop. He's a really good shortstop, you know that?
No, I didn't.
Seriously, he is. He's got a really
Dad, good... Dad, let's go on to some other
us?
People. Other people!
Wait. Say some more. Casey makes it in the major leagues. I want to hear
Biggie!
It.
Biggie! Biggie's such a wonderful bird.
Camera fright.
Which way did he go? Which way did he go?
Which way did he go, George? I said, see, this is my cousin. She only has to grow about this much to be as tall as me.
Oh, yeah.
You did grow, didn't
I'm going to win the race. Oh, yeah.
Here's my hand.
Come here. I want to get you on here.
Beautiful?
Yes. Wait a minute, no, Micah.
Well,
Micah, come here a minute.
Micah.
Yeah.
Come here for just a minute. I want to have you all on the camera at the same time.
Ready and go. Which way did he go? Which way did he
camera
go?
Camera fight again.
Hey, I'm the host here.
Okay, let's pretend that we are retarded like a
sausage. No. Don't do that. That's not nice. That's not nice.
But I do
what do you mean pretend you're retarded and not? You already are.
We can still do that.
Oh, God.
Will this show you cross-eyed?
Oh, God, Lauren, that is disgusting.
Will this show you cross-eyed? Because I've never seen myself cross-eyed. You got it against my...
Which way did it go?
Anna, let me talk to you for
one
just
plus
a minute.
One is... Okay. Yeah.
Watch.
Okay, yeah.
I'd like to know how your summer has been here this summer.
Horrible!
Oh, wait, in order for me to talk, I need one cousin here.
Me.
Yeah, Micah might be too big to sit in
there. Yeah, I think I can sit in Micah.
Yeah, fine.
Tell me about your summer.
Be back.
No.
I'll catch you later. Tell Evan to come up for a minute.
You say Uye Idrilay in Piglet.
Of course, back up.
Great. Why is that? Well, just tell me about it.
It's been a great summer, Bond. I got to spend a whole bunch of time.
Hey, Dad, here comes Sarah and Bear Bear.
Well, yeah, put him on me also.
Okay. See, point the camera down. Okay, this is Sarah and Bear Bear, and these are her new glasses, her reading glasses. And look at the back. Aw, a heart. Upside down one. Okay. And here are their lovely children. Rufflejet, see? And
and cucumber dip. See? They love each other. They're twins and they play nicely. They love their parents and that's their family. Aren't they a nice family?
Now, did they get married?
Yes.
When did
Sarah
they get
married? Sarah Bear have been married now for about
a year.
Not quite a year.
Where'd they get married? Stay in here one more
they
minute.
They got married at the cabin on New Year's Eve.
Okay.
Actually,
where's the cabin?
It's in North Georgia.
Okay.
And
where exactly?
Unicoi State Park.
Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, wait, I'm not done.
Bite my head.
Are you okay, Dad?
The cameraman banged his head.
I'm sorry.
These Americans.
Okay, and
Americans.
And we had a big party. It was on the first day of 1994, January 1st, 1994, their wedding day.
So
the
Ben
Ali walks them down the stairs of the cabin. You, Bear Bear, take Sarah Bear as your lovely wife. I do. Do you, Sarah Bear, take Bear Bear as your lovely husband?
I do.
You are now husband and wife.
All right, let me talk to Anand a few minutes now.
Okay, time for Anand. Bye-bye.
All right, Anand, now tell me about your summer.
What do you want to hear?
Anything you want to talk about.
This has been the great summer of my life. I need a cousin on my legs. I really do. I can't talk for myself. Robin, get over here. Get over here. Okay. This has been the great summer of my life for a couple reasons. The first reason is that I get to stay with my aunt and with my uncle and with my three little cousins. That's the first reason. I get to spend time with them and I get to wake up every single morning and see my cousin Robin picking her nose. That's the best reason. And I think one of the things that I really love is Paula. I think by the year 2000, Paula will finish painting her desk. By the time she goes to college, that's going to be a college present to you guys. The desk. She'll finish that in the next 4 or 5 years, I guess. So, Ron, do you think my voice changed since the movies that we saw then?
That's a good question. I don't know.
We have to go and see if it changed. And I had a great time in camp. Most of the time.
Tell me a little about camp. What camp are you at, first of all?
Camp is at the Altman in Sabin Park, just 10 minutes away from here.
It's 5 minutes away.
5 minutes away from here. And I work at another small camp called Camp High. It's about a half an hour from here.
Shirley Blumenthal Park, that is.
Thank you, my dear help assistant. And I work there once a week, and there I'm an activity director for nature. And in Camp Isidore Altman, I was supposed to do scouting, but someone decided to give me the most job in camp, and they made me the outdoor cooking lady, didn't they?
So what kind of stuff have you cooked this summer?
Pita bread and popcorn and s'mores, and what else did we cook? Garlic bread, and what else have we been doing? Potatoes and all kinds of things like that. It's been really, really good. And, of course, it has been raining almost every single day since I came here because it's going to stop raining on August 23rd, the day I leave, and it's never going to be such a rainy summer again, but this is a special rainy summer, especially for me.
Yep.
1994. Yep. Especially for me. And as much as I called God and I phoned him and I begged him that it won't rain again, it has been raining all the time over and over again. See, he hasn't been listening to me.
He hates you or not?
No, he loves me, but there are more important plays that he has to listen to.
Look, Anand, look at the computer, Daddy.
Oh, look at that.
She's making a little slime.
I like that.
Good. This is for you.
Thank you. I still can't use the computer. The only person that is gonna be born in the 20th century, die in the 21st century, and will not know how to use a computer, and that little time.
Do you have any plans
probably
to learn?
Probably true, Dad.
You think so?
What?
You have any plans to learn it?
Not in the next couple of years.
Why don't you let them teach you tonight?
I knew how to use a computer at home. I really knew how to use it. I even knew how to turn it on and how to put a disk and everything, but I forgot. It's just not important to me. Mom says that when it becomes important to me, I'll know how to use a computer. It's like when things are important for you in life, you learn how to use them.
Mm-hmm.
That's all. It's like my father doesn't know how to use the VCR. He doesn't.
Okay, what is today's date?
Today is
August
14th. August 14th.
What year?
You are sitting, 1994, you are sitting in the room that has been my room for the last 2 months. Now, you claim that this is a bottle of gun. I'm telling you that this is not a bottle of gun. In order for you to get a picture of a bottle of gun, you had to read this room about 5 weeks ago or even 3 days ago. This room is now neat and straight. This is my package that I'm shipping up to New York. Right here, you see?
Mm-hmm. Well, I want to show what a non-balagan is. Yeah. This is not a balagan. Now, tell us what a balagan is. What is a balagan?
A balagan is when everything that is supposed to be in this box, and it is in this box now, is all over the room. It's on the floor. A balagan is when you can't see the color of your carpet, and we can see the color of the carpet now. So this is not a balagan.
So what would you say a balagan is? A mess? How would you define a balagan?
Yes, it's a mess, a balagan.
Okay. And this is not?
No, this is not. It's not very straightened, but this is not a balagan. So definitely not. No.
And I've enjoyed living here this summer.
I loved it.
Why is that?
I'm going to miss you all very, very much. It was a very, very special summer.
Lieutenant in the Israeli Army. Anybody worried about us?
Yes.
This man had control over men and women of the Israeli army. This is the future of the nation of Israel. He could be the future of Benjamin Netanyahu. He could be the future of Yitzhak Rabin.
I can't ride a
bicycle.
Stop.
All right, now, Anat, you're laughing so much. Who is this that you're laughing at?
Elon.
Elon who?
Elon
from Nashville.
Oh, he lives in Nashville, but I thought he was a lieutenant in the Israeli Army.
Brian, if we don't get into the car.
There it is, the future of Israel walking in front of us. God help us. God help us. God help Israel.
Hello. Hi, my name is Robin Worthing, and this is a Nazi camp that she worked at this month. Well, it's already over. I'm gonna be sad when she leaves.
You will be?
Very.
You think I'll hug and kiss her?
Here they are. Elon and Anat. Walking over there. They took.
All right, Anat, it's on. Tell us what's happening up here.
Now it's 1994, 1995, and 1996, and 1997, and 1998, and in the year 2000, when you walk by this path, and you look at this, and you see my name right here, Anat, you'll always remember me and the summer of 1994 that we spent here. I was a counselor at this camp. You'll always, always remember this. I don't know how long this will stay up on this wall. Hopefully it will stay for many, many years, but you'll always remember this.
Tell us about each one.
This is what Kieran and me and Avital worked on for a couple nights before camp was over. There's the shalom, good shalom, the pigeon, and the menorah,
pigeon.
The Israeli flag.
What word is below the flag?
Dagon. That's the Hebrew word for flag. And Shabbat shalom. Got all the candles and the challah and the wine. The map of Israel. The chovot. You know what that is.
That's where she lives.
Well, uh-huh. What does it say below Rehovah?
My name.
And what else does it say above you? Above that.
Rishon LeZion, where Vital is.
She was another Shalichim?
Yep. And Shmeret, where Kion lives. That's a Moshav. And we got here Israel and the Shlichot and our names.
It says Avital and then Kiran and then Anat.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And the month of the year. And the alphabet in Hebrew.
Are there
we
any
mistakes? There's one mistake, and we just added another letter. So now there are 23 letters in the alphabet.
And how many are there supposed to be?
22.
Okay. Did you have fun doing this?
Sure did.
Tell me what it was like working at Zabin this summer in general.
Oh,
Why did we get that on tape already?
Yeah, we'll do it just for another minute.
Why did we get that on tape?
And how are we doing today? This is where an octoton worked. But now, camp's over. What sad thing. She was sad.
Wait. Yes, I am.
She was sad. This is where she did her
apple.
Whatever that means. Okay. Let's see. This over here is where she cooked all her things. Aww. So sad.
There you go. You know how to take a picture in this camera?
What do I do?
Okay.
We'll get you. Describe what this is and so forth.
We didn't do this on this video. Okay. This is my outdoor cooking shelter. Very aloof. Okay. And. The group is to come and sit up here at a table, add all the things on the table. And this is where we had a fire going. Most of the summer we couldn't use wood because it rained here almost every single day. So instead of wood, we used charcoal. That's what we did most of the summer. We used to get a little fire here. At some point, the kids used to go and collect wood from all over this area, bring it back, and we used to get a fire from wood. We used to get some cooking, we used to play games about Israel, songs. Is my cousin teasing me or am I imagining?
No, she wouldn't do that.
No, she wouldn't. And that's what I used to do here the whole summer.
What kind of cooking did you do?
Let's see what we made. We made pita bread, we made s'mores, potatoes, garlic bread, popcorn.
Are you about to go on a trip? Where are you going?
We're going for 4 days to a couple of five, a week or so. We're going to New Orleans. Then I'm going out west.
Who are you going to New Orleans with?
I'm going with Elon. That's standing on your
right. Right there. Look.
Well, I'll get him in just a minute.
Elon, come in.
Elon, you got to get in for a minute.
See, Elon has a problem. He came all the way from Nashville, and he hasn't been talking the whole summer because he is such a shy person. He's very, very shy. He does not have a sense of humor at all. At all. He did not ride Robin's bike this morning. He did not. Did you?
Ride. He rode my bike.
He did. I think I have it on tape.
I think this place looks beautiful, and we should sue the camp director for neglecting the Israeli shtika. This place looks bad.
Wait, did you have better condition?
Yeah.
Well, you see, this is what I did the whole time. The truth is, if I would have done scouting like I was supposed to do, I would have a better shelter than this. But outdoor cooking is the bottom, the most lowest profession that anybody ever wants to do in camp, so I got it.
I wonder why.
I wonder why also. I really wonder why. They couldn't find anyone to do outdoor cooking, so they took me.
But what did Avital do?
Avital did Israeli folk dancing and Kieran did nature.
Oh. Where are you traveling with this young man?
What?
Where are you going to travel around the United States?
Out west. Be in California, Nevada, Las Vegas.
Nevada.
We're gonna be in LA. San Diego. For 10 weeks, people have been laughing at my accent. And the reason they've been laughing at my accent is not because it's an Israeli accent.
Because it's a New York accent.
Because I have some words that are like a New York accent and some words that I don't pronounce at all the right way like the Israelis do.
Nevada.
What did they say?
Like, I don't know.
Nevada.
It's not Nevada, it's Nevada.
What is it?
Nevada.
Take it out. Wait, Elon, I got to ask you one quick question. Who are you traveling around the United States with now?
Alone. Oh. I changed my plans. This minute. I'm going alone.
Now, who are the Meshuggah?
I'm going to have four girls in the trunk. One person driving.
Car, Nuri, and two other people.
Who are the name of the names of the young ladies? I know you're going with the nod. I really don't know. I know Nareen. Who else?
Shelly and Sharon.
You think you're going to survive the next month?
No.
No? You've made it through the Israeli army.
Yeah.
But you don't think...
I don't prepare you for Fargo. Maybe two, but not four.
What was it like working in Nashville this summer?
Fine. Better than here.
Why was that?
Sure. It's a good camp. A small, good camp. Looks better. And that's it.
Our great Israeli generals who plan all kinds of important battles.
Yeah, right.
And then there are other Israeli lieutenants and sergeants who plan trips through the United States.
No, sure. Anat,
right. What was the name of the young man you went out with some this summer?
Brian, can you leave this alone?
Yeah, just one thing. Just say Brian Ross Granite.
Brian Ross Granite. Since this last summer, I did not have the chance to thank you and Alice for the useful present you sent me. And so, better late than never. Happy New Year. That was my father.
What'd you send him?
For a battery-powered screwdriver. An electric
screwdriver. It all the time. He uses it all the time.
Mom.
Morning. No, but it is.
Please don't lean back in this
chair. Okay. Wait a minute, hold it. What's today's date? Enough.
Today is, and I wrote it here the Israeli way, okay? August 22nd, 1994.
No, that was the wrong
word. Now, one other
you
thing.
You do it the wrong
way. Stop
lying.
Before you start, you gotta, I want you to introduce everybody at this table, because in 50 years, your children will be looking at this. I'm serious. Then you can do your speech.
No,
we're not. Go ahead.
We are now sitting at the one time. Can I join you? We just lost some of our members, thanks to you, Brian. I want people to listen to this speech. This is supposed to be a serious.
She said it in English. She was so mad.
Yes, and I will not land today.
Well, go ahead. This is serious, right?
I'm going to cry. This
is
major
serious. This is major serious.
Put the chair down.
Brian, Alice, Paula, Evan, and Robin, and I'm apologizing now for some grammar mistakes. So, how do you sum up 2.5 months? Believe me, it's not easy. I'm sitting in your kitchen trying to look back at these last few months. So many good memories and special moments came up to my mind. By the way, I'm already crying. At this point, I was already crying when I wrote it. One of the first things I remember of June 10th is coming into your house and receiving a feeling of home. There are so many things I'm thankful for. First, thanks for having me spend this summer with you. Thank you for loving, caring, worrying about me. Have a lot of patience to listen to all my nonstop motor mouth. Being there for me at some, not too many, hopefully, difficult moments. Always having an extra hug for me. You are all very, very special people, and each one of you left me some great memories. Robin. I guess people know what they are saying when they say you're the cutest. Every time I'm around you, I feel again like an 8-year-old, and it's great. All our little talks really meant a lot to me. Evan, I know I'm a girl, but I'll never forget our special man-to-man talks. And of course, not our bet. By the way, I'm going to win the bet.
I'm going to win the bet. I'm going to win the bet.
Sneaking out at midnight to go to Kroger's. In a couple of years, you are going to conquer the Israeli gold.
I know.
If someone would have told me that a 14-year-old...
This question has to say to Georgia, oh, you conquered Georgia.
I know you conquered Georgia, that's why you have to come to Israel.
What a jerk!
If someone would have told me that a 14-year-old could be so mature and understanding, I would find it hard to believe. It was a pleasure sharing secrets with you and talking into the night. You are terrific. Brian and Alice. Every child gets only one pair of parents. This summer, being so far away from home, you two did the best you could by listening, caring, and loving. I tried to listen to you and learn as much as I could and as possible. Our family lives far from each other, but the love between them is tremendous. I'm proud to be an Israeli and to have gotten this opportunity to come and represent my country. You all have a place in my heart and are always welcomed in Israel. Just keep on being who you are. Let's all work on our
connection between the two families. I'll never forget the summer of 94, and every time looking back at it, I'm sure I'll get a great big smile on my face. Remember, you always have people in Israel who love you. I'm taking my win with me out west, and then where it really belongs, back home. Thanks for everything, all my love and love.
I love you.
I hate you.
I love you.
Oh, here! Narita, how come you're not crying? Narita, what is it like to be a Knott's friend? I mean, day to day.
It's crazy.
Knott!
Oh, it's gonna be quiet. I don't know how can I survive after being a friend of a Knott.
It's kind of messy on the computer.
You're not. I sure will miss it. One, two, three, four.
Dude, it was a little hard, but since I'm flexible.
It's just because it.
No, since I'm flexible, and my.
Just because this rope is.
That's not only it.
Here, do it to me! Do it to me!
This, and I got it out. No. Still gotta get out with my legs.
It's a this is something they taught you in the
end. Go ahead.
One more time, Elon. I didn't get the whole thing.
Come on, one more time.
No, do Robin one more time. Do Robin one more time.
Me.
Do Robin one more time.
Oh. Whoa.
No.
Brian, can you get me up that high?
No.
Ready? One, two, three. Woo! Elon, we'll try.
Excuse me, who is this famous basketball player over here? Wait a minute. What is he? Narit was an Olympic basketball star?
Yeah.
Is that it? Or is that another Narit?
What?
Narit, aren't you an outstanding basketball player?
Out.
Almost.
It's Matt.